क्लास 5 कंप्यूटर चैप्टर 4 एडवांस्ड फीचर्स ऑफ वर्ड प्रोसेसर 2 पार्ट 3 टॉपिक्स फॉर टुडे आर इंसर्टिंग वर्ड आर्ट इंसर्टिंग पिक्चर्स एडिंग पिक्चर्स फ्रॉम योर कंप्यूटर एंड एडिंग ऑनलाइन पिक्चर्स एंड लेट्स नो मोर. Dear children, I hope you have gone through the previous video and done your homework. Today, in this section of, in this part, we are going to learn how to insert word art in Word document. This is another feature of this MS Word 2016 where you can give effect to your letters, the text. That is the alphabets or any symbol or any number, you can give effects to it. Let's read this chapter one by one, read these paragraphs and I will explain you how we can do this. The word art feature allows you to create special text effects. It gives a unique look to the text. Using word art, you can create decorative effects such as curved, wavy, shadowed, three-dimensional, etc. So these are the effects which you can give to your word or the letters. So how do we do this? The process is select the text on which you wish to apply this word effect, like curved or wavy, shadowed or three-dimensional word you want to show. For that, you need to select that particular text. Then click on the insert tab. So you go to the insert tab and you click on that. Once you click on that, select the word art symbol which looks like this with an A symbol you see here like this, and below that word art will be written in the text group. So once you click on the first step is insert tab. Once you click on the insert tab, in the ribbon you will see the text group, and that text group there are so many icons you can see, like text box, text here on the picture you see here, picture figure 4.5, you have to click on this highlighted word art here. Can you see this? I'm in zooming in, you can see this word art, you click here. Once you click on this, you see there are variety of text effects given to this letter A. So when you select, if this is how you want your text to be seen, then you have to select whichever when you like you select that effect will be affected on your text. So first step is select the text. Number two, click on the insert tab, then go to the text group. From there you select word art icon, then a placeholder appears with the highlighted text, your text here. So now the placeholder, like in PowerPoint we learned, a dotted box will come where you have to type in your material for the slide. Same way a placeholder comes for your text area where you have to type it and enter the text to replace the placeholder text. So whatever is coming first, when you click on this word art, it will show as word art, the text will be appearing like that. But if you want to replace that, you have to type your own text there. For example, if you want to type apple, you type in apple there. So this is the these are the steps to insert word art in your document. Now we come to the next topic, that is inserting pictures. How can we insert pictures in our document? So let's read this. Adding pictures to your document helps you to illustrate the information in a better way. It also enhances the appearance of your document. Word 2016 allows you to add pictures from your computer or from the web directly into your document. So this adding picture can be from your whatever you have collected, like your photos, your drawings, your any other picture you have got from your friends that you have stored in your computer can also be used or inserted in your document. And you can also insert picture from web, means from the internet, if you want to insert picture online. There are facilities where you can search the internet and look for pictures and add into your computer, into your document. So how do we do that? Let's see the procedure. Adding picture from your computer, how do we do it? For inserting picture when we want to take from our computer, the first step is click on the insert tab. Select the picture button from the illustration group. So once you click on the insert tab, which group you will go from, look for in the ribbon area, you will be looking at the illustration group, right? For you learned for insert for inserting word art, you went to the which group you went to? See, you went to the text group. So same way, when you insert for inserting picture, you have to go to the illustration group. And then the insert picture dialog box will appear. So from there you have to click on the insert picture. Once you click on the insert picture, the insert picture dialog box like this you see here on in figure 4.6, this dialog box will appear. This is how it will appear, right? This is called the insert picture dialog box. Then the next step is select the image and click on the insert button. So from here you have, if you know the folder, browse through these folders and then click on the image. There are three pictures you can see here. You select any of the one and then click on the insert button, which is here. See, you can see the insert button here. Click on this insert button. So once you click on the insert button, the selected image will appear in your document. This dialog box will disappear and that selected image will come into your document. Format the image by selecting the desired option from the picture styles group on the format tab. So click on the format. So once the picture has come, you, if it looks bigger or smaller, you want to do some adjustment, you want to give for borders to that image or some any kind of formatting to that picture, then you have to go to the format tab, and in that you have to go to picture styles group and then do your formatting of that picture. So this is how you insert picture from your computer into your document. Now how do we add picture, insert picture from online, mean from the web? Adding online pictures. To insert an online picture, follow the given steps. Place the insert on point where you want to display the image. So you have to keep your cursor in your document where you want the picture to be displayed or inserted. Click on the insert tab, online picture. So insert tab, then go to illustration group. In from that illustration group, you have to click on the online pictures, right? Then the insert picture dialog box will appear on the screen. So this is how the insert online picture dialog box will appear like this. Okay, this is the inserting online picture dialog box, where once you get this, enter your search term in the Bing image search box. Bing images, the Bing is the website, search engine where you can, like Google, this is also a kind of search engine where you have to type your term, a keyword for your image. For example, you are looking for some word, some pictures related to healthy food. So you type healthy food. It will display all the images that it can find on healthy images. So you can browse through all the pictures and select the appropriate one. And you can also browse through the inbuilt categories of images by clicking directly. There may be some categories given there, or you can use your keyword to search the search for your image online. Then this will open another screen displaying the images of various categories. So category wise, if you're going, then click on the categories. Select the image. Once you have chosen your image, click on the image and click on the insert button, the same way you did for inserting picture from your computer. The selected image will be inserted in your document. So one thing you have to remember, in Word 2013 you can also add in text box, Word art, online picture and different appropriate options from the insert tab, different shapes, same way like you do it in, if you know how to work on Word 2013, you can easily work on Word 2016 also. Now we learned how to insert pictures from your computer, from online, and then let's now know some more facts. So what's that extra information that we are going to learn today is, you can also use a picture, symbol or a font as a bullet. Means, for example, you have chosen some picture from your computer which you want to use it as a bullet. Like I have used in my main top title page, I have used some circled bullets to show the subtopics, right? So same way, you can use your pictures, your own picture, like you have clicked your picture, that can be used as a bullet also. And how can we do that? By clicking on the drop down arrow of the bullets button. So click on the drop down. There is a drop down button in the bullets option, arrow of the bullets button, and then select define new bullet option. So there is an option for define. You have to define your bullet. So then to apply picture as bullet, select the picture tab from the, if you want to, that the previous one was for the symbol, now for the picture, select the picture tab from the define new bullet dialog box and pick any picture from the file. So you have to remember this, go to the picture tab, then define new bullet dialog box will appear, then pick any picture and that picture will be used as the bullet. Clear, children? Now another information that you have, useful information for you is how to insert symbols and special characters in Word documents. Select the insert. This is the procedure. Insert, symbol, and then symbol drop down button will come. Click on the more symbols option. Choose the desired symbol from the symbol dialog box. So symbols option, when you click on more, the symbol dialog box will appear. Click on the insert button. Once you click on that, that symbol can also be used as a that can also be used in your document. You can insert that in yours, because many a time we cannot find these symbols in our keyboard. So how can we find it? We can find it through these insert symbols and characters and insert it in our document. I hope you have understood whatever I have explained in this section. If you have any problem in any of these topics, please make a note of it in your last page of your computer copy and use the online class if very usefully by asking all these doubts. Because if you don't write it, you will forget what was the doubt. Okay? So you write it somewhere that this is the area that I have not understood, and I will explain you the same in my online class. That's all for today, children. Read this chapter again as many number of times, and any difficulty just underline and make a note of it in your copy. That's all for today, children. Take care.